You know, there are some movies whose plots or storylines seem absurd and wacky, and you think it doesn't make any sense in real life. But when you actually watch them, those movies turn out to be exceptionally good. Leap Year, starring Amy Adams and Matthew Good, is one such movie. When released in 2010, the movie suffered a bad reception, but over the time it has claimed its place as a cult classic, and it is one of my favorite movies too. Today in this video, we will see, was Leap Year actually any good? The movie starts with Anna Brady, played by Amy Adams. In the opening credits, we see her doing her job as stager of the properties for realtors and going to a housing society meeting with her boyfriend of 4 years, Jeremy. Jeremy is a cardiologist who is going to Dublin, Ireland that night for a medical conference. That day, Anna gets information from her friend that she has seen Jeremy leaving a jewelry shop with a diamond gift box, and they both get very excited thinking that he is going to propose her, because it may be an engagement ring in that box. Later, Anna meets her father in a bar. Her father overhears about her supposed engagement and congratulates her. He is happy that finally Jeremy has come around. He claims that since it is a leap year on that weekend, Anna could have proposed to Jeremy. He says that in Ireland, a girl can propose to a guy on a leap year, which is 29th February. But he is happy that Anna doesn't have to do that. That night, Anna and Jeremy are having dinner, and Jeremy gives her the diamond jewelry box. At first, Anna gets excited, but later finds out that it isn't an engagement ring but a pair of diamond earrings. She tries to hide her disappointment from Jeremy, who is in a rush. That night, she googles leap year proposals and finds out that it's an actual thing. She then packs her suitcase and catches a flight to Dublin. However, due to bad weather conditions, her plane has an emergency landing and all the flights are cancelled. However, she is determined to make it to Dublin. She takes a bus and then a connecting ferry in the storm. But the ferry leaves her on the beach of Dingle, a small town. She walks to the nearest restaurant to inquire about the transport to Dublin, but they tell her there is no bus. When she calls on the number for the taxi, it is the barkeeper Declan who picks it up. He refuses to drive her there because, according to him, Dublin is full of backstabbing people. Defeated, Anna decides to look for a taxi in the morning and asks Declan to stay there. He puts her in a room and goes to make her a sandwich. Meanwhile, she short circuits the entire village while trying to charge her phone. From here onwards, their funny rivalry starts. In the morning, she calls her boyfriend and gives him the news that she is in Ireland. She tells him that she will be there in the afternoon. Then she overhears Declan arguing about the money he's supposed to repay to the debt collector. When Anna is getting ready, Declan barges in and declares that he will drive Anna to Dublin for 500 euros. He takes advantage of her indecent state to pull a yes from her, and she finally agrees. When she comes out, she sees Declan's old rusty car. The old men tell her that it is a bad luck to start a journey when a black cat crosses you. After some bickering, Declan and Anna start their journey to Dublin in Declan's car. During the drive, Anna confesses her real reason for going to Dublin. She mentions the great Irish tradition of girls proposing to their boyfriends on leap day. However, Declan starts laughing because it's the stupidest thing he has ever heard. This makes Anna angry and she throws his sandwich out of his car and then his loud music cassettes. Declan stops the car and they both get out to fight some more. This goes on for a while, and in between the cows on the road and Anna's shoes dipping in the cow dung, Declan's car slips downhill and slides into a pond. They continue to fight and begin the rest of the journey on foot. After a while, a van approaches them. Despite Declan's warning, Anna stops the van. A shady-looking guide comes out and offers his help taking Anna to her destination. However, he puts her suitcase in the van, and before she can get in, he drives off along with her belongings. Frustrated and shocked, Anna walks some more to a nearby bar and finds Declan is already sitting there. She asks the barman for a landline phone. While she waits in line for her turn, she sees the gang who stole her suitcase in the pool room, and they are going through her belongings. Seeing this, she barges in and demands her suitcase back, but they threaten her. Later, in a heroic fashion, Declan intervenes and a bar fight ensues. In the end, the bar owner throws everyone out and both of them escapes with her things. They are on the road again. Declan comments that her boyfriend must be special. What he meant was, if she is going so much trouble for someone, then he must be special for her. To that, she is at a loss for words and instead replies that he is a cardiologist. Then they reach a small railway station, and there she learns that the next train to Dublin leaves in almost 3 hours. While waiting for the train, Declan entices Anna to visit a nearby castle. At first she refuses, but later joins him for the trek. Declan asks Anna if her house is on fire and she only has 60 seconds to go, what she will say, what is so valuable for her not to leave behind, but she has no definite answer. While climbing the hill, Declan tells the story of a famous medieval couple who has taken a refuge in that castle while on the run. It was a beautiful story about love. However, Anna accuses him of hitting on her. When their train arrives, they are on the top of the castle, and in her haste of running down the hill, Anna slips and gets all muddy and wet and misses her train by seconds. Turns out it was the last train of the day. The station master takes them to his own bed and breakfast joint, but his wife insists that they lend rooms only to married couples. So Anna and Declan pretend to be married and get a room for the night. In the room, they flip a coin for the bed, but Declan wins by cheating. Anna realizes it later and bashes him for lying and tells him he has to sleep in the bathroom as he won by lying. The hostess asks them for dinner, but Declan offers to cook for everyone instead. Next, we find our fake couple in the vegetable garden. Perfectionist Anna is having trouble finding the right size carrot for the recipe, but Declan tells her to chill and have little faith in him, which again triggers Anna because her father used to tell her that everything will work out, but nothing ever did anymore. She had to work 2 jobs and support her family from a very young age. Declan agrees with her and tells her that a father should be someone you can rely on. Later, they prepare dinner together. They share some good moments between them and grow friendly towards each other. During the dinner, everyone praises the chicken they prepare. Anna mentions Jeremy, but Declan covers for her, telling he is their neighbor. Their conversation circles around romance and marriage and the kiss. The Italian couple demonstrates their long, passionate kiss, which makes others slightly uncomfortable. When their host pushes Declan and Anna to kiss each other, they deny at first, but on further probing, Declan kisses Anna and she responds to it. It is a passionate and deep kiss, surprising them both. That night, they have to share the only bed in the room, but they can't sleep as both of them are thinking about that date's events. In the morning, Declan brings breakfast for Anna but overhears her talking to Jeremy, and his expression changes. Anna inquires about the train timetable to the innkeeper, but he says there are no trains on Sundays. She asks if she can borrow his car to Dublin, even willing to pay a substantial money for it. Their host says that his wife Eileen has taken their car to Dublin in the morning, and she won't be back anytime soon. Then again, Anna and Declan start walking towards the bus station, but a sudden rain of hailstones make them take shelter in a church where a wedding is in progress. Later, they enjoy hospitality as wedding guests. Declan says he hates weddings. When Anna accuses him of never being in a committed relationship, he says he was once engaged, but then refuses to further elaborate. In the evening, when everyone is dancing, Anna and Declan dances with other people. But with her luck, Anna's shoes flies off and hits the bride in her forehead. Then Anna accidentally spills red wine on the bride's dress. Embarrassed and drunk, Anna sits on the beach of the lake, and when Declan comes to talk to her, she throws up on his shoes. When morning comes, they are sleeping on a bench at the bus station. When Declan wakes up, he doesn't find Anna near him. He thinks that she has gone to Dublin without him, and for a moment he is disappointed and heartbroken. Then Anna comes from behind him, telling him that she will be deducting his coffee from his bill. Then they take a bus to Dublin. When they reach there, Anna calls Jeremy, but he is out. So again, they walk around beautiful Dublin and spend some time together. In a pub, Anna comments that she has not seen any cheater or chancer in Dublin yet. She guesses that Declan's ex-girlfriend may be living there. He tells her how his ex-girlfriend, his ex-best friend, were his partners in the bar business, how his ex-girlfriend cheated with his best friend. And he also tells Anna that the only thing he would save in those last 60 seconds, if the times come to it, is his mother's ring, which is still with his ex-girlfriend. Then Anna tells him to get it back from her since he's there already. Anna is curious if Declan cares that she's engaged to Jeremy. Then he asks her what difference it would make even if he is. It means that he likes her in a romantic way now, but he's happy for her anyway. At the hotel, she tries to give him money as part of the deal, but he doesn't accept, settling only for the coin they flipped for the bed. Then Declan tries to say something, but in a cliche fashion, Jeremy interrupts them. He proposes to Anna in the hotel lobby in front of everyone. When Anna looks up, Declan is gone. Then she says yes to Jeremy and they are engaged. Then we see Declan calling and meeting his ex-girlfriend in a bar. We see Anna and Jeremy going back to Boston and Declan gets busy running the bar and even manages to save it from debt collectors. Meanwhile, Anna and Jeremy move into their new apartment. They are having a party and Anna's friend says she is so jealous of Anna for getting the apartment, she might throw her out of the window. Then Jeremy tells the story of how the housing committee member called him when he was in Dublin and asked about their marital status. He also confesses that he proposed to Anna because he thought it would guarantee them the apartment. Anna feels betrayed. She stands alone and sad. When the fire alarm blares loudly, Jeremy is disappointed. He starts collecting all the electronic devices while Anna watches him teary-eyed. She feels she's not the most important thing for Jeremy to save in the last 60 seconds. Scene cuts to Ireland and to Declan's bar. In the kitchen, Declan's staff brings a chicken dish. A customer has complained about it. Angry, Declan goes to confront the said customer but finds Anna there. She tells him that she is no longer with Jeremy and she confesses her feelings to him. But instead of replying to her, he goes back, taking it as a no. Embarrassed and tearful, Anna storms off to the sea cliff nearby. However, we see that Declan returns and calls her from behind. He tells her he went back to get his mother's ring, which he was holding only for Anna. Then he proposes to her and she says yes. The movie ends with them driving off in their old car with just married written on its back. Leap Year was released in 2010. It was not a leap year and the movie was not that successful. The plot of the movie is not all fictional. There is really an old tradition for the Irish girls to propose to their men on leap day. I have linked the article in the description. But Irish people had some complaints with the movie for stereotyping them. Despite this, the movie has gathered quite a fan base since then. It is now counted as one of the most watched rom-com of all time. Leap Year is a funny, enemy-to-lovers romantic movie. Although the plot seems improbable and dialogues are not that great, the beautiful scenery of Ireland and the lovely chemistry between Amy Adams and Matthew Good makes this movie worth re-watching many times. The spectacular and scenic natural wonders of Ireland makes the movie so breathtakingly fresh and warm, it uplifts your mood. I'm sure like me, many have put Ireland on their bucket list after watching this movie. Now the plot may seem exaggerated, but we have to remind ourselves that sometimes we make a fool of ourselves when we visit a new place or meet new people. Anna even comes off as stupid and clumsy in the story, but we all have done some stupid things for the people we love. What I absolutely love about this movie is that, unlike it may seem, Anna does not dump her boyfriend of 4 years for a man she just met. Instead, she says yes to Jeremy, goes back with him and tries to make a home with him. She thinks that she is getting what she always wanted. But her dreams shatter when she realizes that their feelings, priorities and goals are not the same. And that's when she thinks of going to Declan and expressing her feelings. Still, it isn't easy for her because there is a chance that Declan may reject her. And he does at first. But as per the rule of rom-coms, we get our happy ending. And it's okay if it doesn't work in the long run. At least she took a chance from her obsession of perfection. She took a leap in love that year. And that's it for today. Please tell us in the comment which movie you would like us to do in the next video. Love ya. Bye.